front. It is going to be D Inferno versus this Swedish BYOC qualifier against Titan. And you all know Titan. They don't need any introduction. Kenny S, MBK, Scream, Smiths in existence will be starting off on the terrorist side as they had lost the knife round against the Swedish team o4o. And I hope o4o is the right word to use. Well, or the right name.
I'm sure someone will call us out if we're wrong, but... But
it's 0-0, not 0-0.
Cool opening on the pistol round here. Of course, you know, 3-man aggression going from o4o. Again, get that map control, get the map under control. So you know what's happening. They've managed to do that. They've managed to fall back now. You can see they moved in with 3. Now they're falling back with 2. Titan, though, they are playing a little bit smarter. Actually still hanging around. Forcing the push now. Bit of a delayed push on Banana. And o4o now have to rotate back with that floater. And they do not have good positions. They're going to have to play for this retake. They cannot defend the site. And Crispy's saying in the chat, game is for this. But of course, it's going live now. There's no questioning it. And Scream and Existence getting some frag. Crispy, go. Not looking so good for o4o.
Textbook B push there. By the Titans themselves, the Frenchmen showing how it's done on Inferno. Only losing 1 man in that pistol round, so very good job by them as they get themselves the first round. 1-0 up to the Frenchmen on this relatively CT-sided map, I would say.
They love the cameras. Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. So, Daniel, so loving up the cameras, just enjoying.
Love those cameras.
There you go, camera angles.
I know, it looks great.
It's nice.
It adds a lot. I mean, some of the angles are really good. Look at this one's really nice.
Oh, that's a nice angle. You can see him scurry to their position. We have 3 men at A at the moment and 2 and B. Standard little split here. No aggressive pushes. They're taking it easy. It is an eco round by them, but interestingly enough, we do have 3 Galils here near the T site. MBK gets shot down and Banana, but is able to finish the job with a pretty easy double kill on Wacky and Fesco. And I know that today we will be butchering the names of these players. There is no doubt about that. So we're very sorry in advance. Existence catching one of the CTs slipping there in second mid. Last man standing is Quicks here in the bomb site with the 5-7. Won't be able to do any damage with that. So relatively powerful weapon, but sadly, yeah, we do have a pause here by o4o.
So as we can talk about the way that the metagame has shifted. I mean, this is just, I mean, a lot of players are going to say, I know this already, you're not telling me anything new, but this is for some of the newer players as well. So we see, of course, you know, AK from MBK, and 3 Galils, and then a CZ for Kenny S. So there's no SMGs there, there's no shotguns, there's no, you know, no weapons that are going to give you any, you know, significant bonus with any kills for the money. And this is the reason for this is because of the way that things have shifted when it comes to, you know, PT-50 armor buys and CZ armor buys. So apparently there's a crash, so I'll just keep talking about that for a brief moment. So the obvious counter here is to make sure that you're not using an SMG, because the armor penetration is really, really bad with weapons like that. So you're going to really have a lot of troubles taking them down. So keeping better weapons for longer ranges is much safer overall. And this is what we tend to see nowadays, is, you know, stuff like the Galils and maybe an AK. Depends on the map, depends on the positions, but that's quite standard place. And Kenny S is saving for that AWP.
Exactly, he's saved, he's kept the CZ. I mean, the Galil is not really a horrible choice. It's slower than an AK-47, does a bit less damage, but it's got a pretty close accuracy when it comes to the AK-47. It's a rifle. At the end of the day, it's better than all the other SMGs, and it's relatively well priced. So these days, as you said, due to the second round armor buys by the CTs, or by the losing side of the pistol round, you do get to see more rifles.
Certainly. So actually, if we could jump back into the game, I could draw on the map a little bit, because that's always fun. Get my art going in the morning. Maybe draw some smiley faces. So there we go. So of course, we're paused at the moment, but we have the map to occupy ourselves. And
nice squiggly line there. It looks really beautiful.
Definitely. So again, talking about metagame again, I want to highlight this for any of the new players watching the stream. I know we do have such an influx of new players again and again. So, you know, typical setup, let's talk about that. The very typical setup is, you know, 2 players on B, and, you know, they playing crossfires, you know, 1 in the site, maybe 1 towards CT spawn here. So that's very, very typical. And you have, of course, you know, the guy on arch, the guy on quad, and maybe, you know, guy in apartments playing around here. That's like the most typical setup ever for this map on a CT defense. But if we look at how the map works, you have potentially all this area for the terrorists to occupy. You have all this area, all the way up to mid. It's a terrible drawing here with this wireless mouse, and all of apartments is possible. So they can get all this area. I don't know what that looks like. I mean, that's like looks like something you'd show.
It looks like those
splotches that psychologists like show patients. Like, what does this look like?
For me, it looks like those rocker fingers. You know, like the guy, the rock. You know, people who like rock music, they do the.
Oh right, yeah.
Yeah, like wow, the, what nice. Is it? I forgot the name of it. It's just a hand sign, but yeah.
Indeed. But either way, I mean, this is all about map control here. And the kind of fundamental problem of just having like this side of the map with map control is you really don't know what's going on. So we see that teams started to adapt. The metagame changed in a way that allows CTs to be much more proactive, making for a more aggressive game and a game which is much more interesting because it's all about that battle for information. So in that, in light of that battle for information, the easiest way for CTs to get information is to use like deep smokes down like around here, so toss deep smokes over and get positions around here because now they have a great choke point, which is this area here. And if it's smoked off, I mean, look how small that area is. It's so small we can actually zoom over there, and it's so good to defend. You can leave one guy to actually comfortably defend here if you use smokes effectively. You've got two or three guys there. The first guy throws a smoke, then you leave the guy who's got the smoke. He re-smokes that later on. Like a lot of delay, a lot of extra time for you to force your opponents to do something. Yep. So it's a really, really standard metagame and these days. And that's what these are the kinds of things. It's very difficult to do effectively because, of course, the terrorist teams are going to do counterplays. But we are live now, so let's go into that.
And one thing I'd also mention with the way CTs play is that as a CT, you cannot have the same static positions because once the terrorists know where the CTs are, they can throw those effective flashes and smokes and to really negate the ability of the CTs to defend the bombsite. And that's also why some of the CTs go for those pushes in the middle of the game. But we do have the third round of today's game as o4o will be on a full eco. Madman with a CZ.
So things are quite slow here. And Titan always going to be waiting for that perfect moment to strike.
Yeah, they'll be taking their time. Kenny has yet my weapon. Still with a CZ. He does have a Molotov though. We do have two Molotovs. Perhaps Titan are thinking of a barbecue. NDK. Very confident going into the bombsite, but they're not confident enough. And as Fesco will get the kill on him, existence there with the revenge. They do know that there's nobody in bombsite B, unless they've stacked it. But Titan are very, very wary indeed. One man is in bombsite A. They know that at least. Ooh. He gets a kill on Kenny S. Not bad at all there by Quicks. Good CT spawn. Smoke's going to put Crispy out of the combat, but he's going to push through that smoke. He's going to take that risk, and he's definitely going to take them by surprise, but he's going to miss those very, very important shots on Scream. Scream turning around will get that headshot almost immediately, and now the last man standing is Quicks there. It would have been a bit of a different story if he had survived. Picking up the CZ, we'll be going towards bombsite B through Banana, and he'll have one or two terrorists waiting for him eagerly. Unable to do any damage, he will have to go down. Titan getting a standard anti-eco round there, 3-0, although they looked a bit rocky early on.
I've got to say, from the very little I've seen of Quicks, this is the first time I've seen him play actually, Quicks has a very snappy and very clean aim actually, so I'm quite curious to see how that goes. He's already looking, I mean, we've only seen like two frags from him and one from another teammate on this team, but he's looking like a very strong player, so I want to see how this actually develops. They're going for the three-man aggression.
Very nice.
To try to take some control on Banana. Titan though, look out, this is easily like the counter plays. Titan don't have to push Banana, but they are saying to o4o, no way are we going to let you have Banana control. They can always fall back and spill back out to the rest of the map with this, and that's the pain for CT, because now they've been denied all the info. So Quicks is going to wait here with the smoke, and he's got a teammate there as well. And they can't really leave Quicks alone here because of how many men that they spotted. And with Kenny S going down, Titan still, you know, having the ability to concentrate four men on a single area, o4o have to give that a lot of respect.
Well, they've done an excellent job with that three-man push down of Banana. Kenny S is down. It's a 5-on-4, and that's forcing the terrorists to spread around the map. We do have two men pushing mid at the moment, trying to see, test the waters over at bombsite A. They're able to take down Crispy, who is hiding that cubby, and MBK will take down Quicks. Now, it looks more free range. MBK actually landing a few shots through that smoke on the CT, but he's still there, and he's still capable of surprising them if he pushes at the right moment. A terrorist just moves right past him. Wacky doesn't see him. He's going to fire and give away position, perhaps. Firing through that smoke there. It's still 3-on-3. It's still possible for o4o to retake the bombsite if they play their cards right. They do have one decoy. I don't know how they're going to use that. Mikey and his teammate pushing in there from Graveyard. And the terrorists doing a good job of not peeking. They're hiding. They're not giving away their positions. Madman able to take one person before Smith's taken down, but they don't have enough time to defuse the bomb. And the best thing they can do right now is save the gun, but Smith's will deny them that with some really nice Galil action there. And there his corpse flies as he loses his life as well. But denying the save for the CTs was a very good move as they're forced onto an eco again. And it's 4-0 from the French Titans.
That looked like the hop, skip, and jump or something from the Olympics.
See how far they go.
That's brilliant. So yeah, four rounds for Titan. I feel like o4o have actually displayed so far, you know, decent understanding of what they're doing. It's just going to be down to the execution. That was all about MBK making a very sick entry frag or two, moving into the B-bomb side. That was all of it really for Titan there, and the big trouble for o4o. Let's see if they can do any better on the next buy round. Of course, we're looking at another eco, but if I were in o4o's shoes right now, I would be saying, you know, okay, let's just stick to what we know. I don't think, you know, we have to adjust to Titan just yet. It's early days, you know, this can be quite a standard thing, you know, losing that first buy round, you know, don't sweat it. It does get very, there's a lot of pressure though, when that happens, because it's like, oh, it's 5-0 now, we've got to win this. But Titan just playing the standard kind of anti-eco, slowly picking apart o4o.
They're very, very, they are checking every single corner. They don't want to make any mistakes. Their attention to detail, honestly, is absolutely fantastic. There is not a corner that they leave unsmoked or a little spot they leave, like, unchecked. And that's nice. Very good for Titan. And it shows how serious they are in this tournament. They're 4-0 up against a team that really isn't a well-known team. They qualified through the public qualifiers. They have some skill to them, and we can see that. But Titan are not... you know, taking them lightly, and they shouldn't as well. But on this eco round, Quix was able to pick up the gun from Smiths. He does have an AK-47. At the moment, his best chance really is to try and save it. He goes to the apartments near T-spawn, and the Titan players know that there is a CT with an AK-47 somewhere nearby, and they're slowly closing in onto his position. They have to be careful that they don't lose too many men too Quix and make it cost more than it deserves, but I think he might be able to survive with that AK-47 and go into the next round with a gun to his name. That wouldn't be a bad start for o4o this time.
So here we go. No AWP spotted there for o4o, and I do like that because, you know, okay, they couldn't afford it, so that's a big factor there. Actually, no, they could have afforded it, but it would have probably come at a price of no armor or something like that. But I do favor kind of the play to like build some more bank first. And let's see what kind of setup we have from o4o. They're going to go a little bit aggressive, but no deep smokes, it seems, just yet on Banana. And Titan not really punching a hole through as strongly as previous. They're just going for mid. They just want this mid. Christie's there with a defense. Does manage to take some player, Kenny Yes down, but that's not nearly enough. There's too many Titan players alive and swarming the A bomb site as Wacky struggles to hold on to the position at Kai. He's going to fall back towards A. But Titan are all over this bomb site. And o4o, what are they going to do about this? This is going to be so difficult to retake.
And that's a little mistake Crispy made there. Going for the man who's further away at the more acute angle than the closer one. And that cost him his life. o4o now losing control of the bomb site, are getting picked off one by one all over the map. The last man standing here is Wacky with his M4. And really, man for man, Titan are just simply playing better CS. They're getting those one-on-ones. o4o, however, are showing us that they're capable. They're very capable of getting one or two kills. They're very capable of defending certain angles and bomb sites. But Titan's execution has not been banned whatsoever. But Wacky doing a great job getting at least two kills. He has to make sure he checks towards bomb site B. But sadly, he won't be able to save his M4. MBK will get that kill, and MBK has been playing absolutely excellently. 9 kills and 2 deaths for him. Mm. He's been doing a great job. Him and Smiths as well. Smiths with 8 kills.
And something to note now is they really went for a force buy. They had no choice, but the nades, that is a big deal here. Let's look at the positions of Crispy and Fuska, because they don't have any nades. They're just going to go with this. This is actually a smart choice, because they've got to be aggressive with this, because they don't have the nades to really put a strong defense on. And that little push, it works out so brilliantly. They managed to take down a couple players, and o4o in a stroke of desperation, that may have just given them the right kind of... or rather removed all the options, left only one. And that was the right option for them. Go a bit aggressive, surprise the French side. And it is still 3-on-5, so this round is far from over, especially against the caliber of players from the French side that we used to. And there goes Smith opening up mid, and Titan are slowly working their way back in this one.
Chris, we should have been aware that he's going to be sitting out. Somebody tried to come in from Apartments, but Fesco will take down Smith, and this is looking relatively good for the Swedish side. We have seen Inferno, where the terrorists are ahead by 6-7 rounds, and the CTs actually catch up and make it an 8-7 or a 9-6 game. So it's definitely possible for o4o. If they win this round and start this momentum going, they can definitely catch up. That was an excellent push there in Banana. Three men pushing towards the terrorists. They didn't expect that. Nice little double nade action, and Scream getting that headshot somehow, some way. I have no idea how he saw it. And these are the kind of caliber of players that can really change the game around. In a 2-on-4 situation, all of a sudden it's 2-on-2. His existence will get a kill on Fesca. And now, Quicks and Wacky, it's all up to them. They're all in bombsite B, or they're coming from bombsite B right now. One in library and the other through mid. And it doesn't look very probable for them to actually clinch this round from Titan. Titan doing an excellent job. We have some amazing individual talents. And you can, as you said earlier, you can definitely not discount them in this 4-on-2 situations. As they stuck to their gameplay, they stuck to their basics, and they slowly push toward bombsite B. But Quicks will take down Scream. Existence with a kill. It's 1-on-1 right here. Quicks will take him down, but I don't think he'll have enough time to defuse the bomb. Maybe enough time to save that AK-47. Very, very close round there, but Titan do get the win, and an unlikely win as well.
Yeah, certainly. I mean, it was a really, really nice retake attempt considering that situation. But if you then think about the start of the rounds, you know, a few quick opening frags pushing Titan to figure, you know, just they had to go, okay, crap, plan A didn't work. We've got to figure something else out now. What do we know about the map? What can we open up for ourselves? Smith's getting pick on mid on Crispy. That really opened up the map for them. And from then on, they created an A play that got them on the site, got them in post-plant situations with that bomb down. That was really, really well done by Titan, and that shows their world caliber class for sure. And they are 7-0 right now. o4o are by no means getting, I mean, I think the score makes it a lot less close than it really is. And Titan are so taking control of the apartments, trying to force those Swedes out of there. Crispy to go down. Madman might be in a good position, and he will take down Screams. That is going to put a wrench in the works there for Titan. But Kenny S will deal with that, and o4o, they're in trouble.
They don't leave any stone unturned. They go for every person, regardless. And you can see as they hunted down Madman, they did not want to have a CT behind them as they planted the bomb. Quicks getting a kill, putting it back to a 3-on-3 situation. And they still have control of the bomb site for a moment yet, as the bomb is down. Kenny S and Smiths, one shot each, taking out both Wacky and Quicks. Smiths with that wall bank. Now it's all up to Fesco with his Mag 7. Do anything. Yes, he's got his crosshair in the right place at the right time, and it's looking increasingly difficult for o4o to come back. o4o to come back into this game,
and I think they're thinking out the buyer, but it would be without nades at all if they were to do that. And Mama's going to get himself a shotgun just because, you know, he's evening up the money there, and that's fine. So we'll see what he can do with that, but by and large, this is looking like a very, very terrible situation for o4o. It's going to be 9 rounds for Titan, realistically, before we start to see anything from them. But let's see if Batman can show us something, maybe pick up a kill on Smith here. If he can just get that angle. Will he know to look left with that Nova? Oh, and he's going to get caught. Smith, unfortunately, for o4o, is going to shut down the shotgun. And it's just Crispy remaining. So o4o, I mean, I think they're just getting out-executed. I don't think it's anything more than just the fact that Titan are just way better players.
I think one of the main issues at the moment is that they're giving away mid a bit too easily without falling back in the correct manner. When you do give away mid, when you do let the T's control mid, you have to move back into better positions. You have to move back behind art side. You have to move back into the library. You have to throw those smokes and those flashes to kind of stop them and try and basically change the front line to a better position for yourself. That's not happening, really. What's happening is they're giving away mid and they're dying at mid. And that's a huge mistake. Once you lose one or two men at mid, it opens up the game. Inferno is not one of those maps where you want to lose one or two men because it really causes a huge imbalance. And then it becomes a guessing game. Which bomb site will the terrorists push into? So the CTs at the moment have to be careful. Again, I think they're playing too close to mid right now. They should play a bit deeper. They do have a full buy right now. They shouldn't have one man in truck side and arch side. That's the standard Inferno that we're used to, but Titan know how to play against this kind of Inferno. But Quicks is going to push out at the wrong moment. Crispy will get a kill all the way from truck side, and he was completely flashed as well. He was just spraying and praying, but it did enough damage. Madman is going to get completely overpowered, and it's just a numbers game right now. Titan are completely outnumbering them in every single firefight. It's always 2-on-1 or 3-on-1 as Fazka just clips Scream, takes him out here on mid. And again, overwhelming odds against o4o. It's 10-0, and the prognosis doesn't look too good.
It certainly looks grave indeed. As would be expected, o4o, of course. These are not, you know, crazy huge names by any means. Everyone on time, Kenny S, NBK, Scream, Smith, Existence. These are massive names in the scene. These are household names in Counter-Strike Global Offensive. These are names that show us new things. They innovate the game. These are huge, huge players. And so o4o to even get a few rounds against them, it's going to be feeling, you know, pretty nice for them. They're not going to be expecting to pull out a victory here. But just making it this far is going to be a good experience for every player. And they're still going to be fighting, though. They're going to be fighting tooth and nail to try to do the best job they possibly can. And Madman is going to be able to open up a frag on Smith. And it's a good start to this round, but we've seen this before. Titan's recovery seems almost impeccable. Let's see if they can do that
The bomb site B defense has to hold right now. It has to hold. Three Titan players will be pushing the resistance. Will he get the first kill? Yes, he will on Wacky. First kill, take down Scream, who was caught on the crossfire of the poor man. And he has to back away. One of the CTs has to quickly re-rotate. And now it's up to Existence to make the right call. Is he going to try and go through bombsite B or go for bombsite A? Right now, it would be better for him to rotate, as we have one, maybe two CTs rotating. And then Fesco will take down Kenny S. And this is not looking good for Titan. It could be the first round they lose this game. And it could be a 10-1.
Existence does this with four health. I will leave. I'll get up. I'm going to throw the headset down. I'm going to walk out that door.
They really, I mean, he's up here on the tree. And I think he's going to... He's going to monkey around for a bit and try and save that AK-47 with four health. I mean, if he falls right now, he probably dies. So he has to be really careful. He has to watch his feet. I don't think anyone's going to get him here. Maybe he'll get one or two kills if they run down Banana, but they don't have to. The bomb is up there. Oh, he sees him. He gives away his position. He's going for that kill. They have no idea. Now they do. Throw the nades. Oh, actually survives. Not bad there by Existence. Wow. Saving an AK-47. Good choice by the team captain.
So round one by o4o, and if they can pull another four together, it's going to be great. And that's really going to be the only option for them, because if they, again, they lose this, money is so bad that they're going to have to eco and they're pretty much done. So got to pull out the next four. Then that will be a somewhat respectable half, respectable enough. It'll be something to work with at the very least. And I do indeed like that we saw from Existence, a bit of his inner child coming out, climbing up that tree. But Quicks, you know, he's shown us that he's pretty good for it. And
that nade. He barely dodged it. He had to matrix that crap. And this is good by o4o, because they're changing their little setup here on mid, and which is pretty much why they're getting those kills. They did not expect to see somebody on top of quad there, boosted on top. And so Quicks is able to get that kill. He's re-rotated. He's moving. They're getting deeper. They're getting away from all those nades and flashes. And they're choosing a better position. And this is putting Titan on their toes. Titan having to decide that perhaps it's better off if they go towards bombsite B and get that entry frag, which they have been able to get in a lot of the rounds.
The MBK the special smokes. With the SIG, man.
Yeah, he loves it. He loves the SIG.
It's in his hands. It is a top tier weapon, better than the AK. Amazing, absolutely amazing. Another frag picked up there by Scream. His job was only to flank, only to distract. But done a great job. It's just two players left. Surely they can finish him off. MBK is just bleeding out at this point, and Existence is quite crippled as well. o4o, this is their round to take. Existence.
Oh la la, Existence. Goodness me. Getting that double kill there. Very, very nice by Existence. Both headshots. Now it's all up to Crispy. There's barely 20 health between the two T plays. He just needs a bullet each. Or maybe a breath of wind. But they're in some really nasty positions here. And it's going to be very, very tough for Crispy to clinch this round. He's going to be shot from the right. Well, actually, that was from MBK. Interesting fight. We'll get the kill on MBK. Won't have enough time to defuse the bomb. Doesn't have a defuse kit left. We'll take down Existence, but that's not really important. It's all about winning the round. It's not about killing your opponents. And so 11-1 to Titan, where Titan shouldn't have really lost that round again.
They're going for the buy. I mean, they have to do it. They just have to, because If they eco again, it's just
there's not enough rounds left.
It's not enough rounds left, and they had enough money to scrap together something. They got two mags in the mix, a deagle over here on first game. Maybe you can get the sniping action going. Deagle's actually really good in this position because you can fire one bullet and back away, and you don't have to worry about recoil. He's gonna have pushed the car, but be careful though, and he's gonna go down there. It seems that Titan are just taking control of the map, and all these little aggressive pushes are being shut down with ease.
Yeah.
As would be expected, but still.
So that push was definitely not as organized or as clinical as the other pushes that they've been doing, you know. Pushing together, throwing those flashes and smokes, and having three men with M4s in unison. It doesn't matter how bad their aim is. It doesn't matter. As long as you have three men pushing like that and firing under, down that funnel, down banana, it's going to cause a lot of damage. But they're trying to go with a deagle and trying to get those shots. It's definitely not going to work. But Quix is in a nice position here with his Mag 7. Can do a lot of damage if they move up in front of him. And he will get the kill on screen. They do know he's in apartments. And they do know there's somebody with a Mag 7. It's probably better for them to just leave him be.
Yeah.
We'll be picking up the AK-47, though. It's 2-on-4 at the moment. And it might be the 12th round for Titan.
Quix is having the best half of anyone on this team. And I think he's definitely shown some really nice skills. So Quix is going to be one to look at for the future for sure. But as far as things go now, as much as Crispy can do here, it's not going to be enough. He's not making this retake. I'm calling it right here. He's calling it as well. His team are as well. Just go for the save, man. Keep that Asimov alive and see what we can do with it in the next round. As Kenny S. Smith and Existence are still alive, and this is going to be a 12-1 scoreline for o4o. The Swedes are not going to be able to tackle the Titans. This is no David Goliath story. David and Goliath story, that's for sure.
You know what? You know Crispy's name is just making me horribly hungry at the moment.
Is it really?
I'm just thinking.
You like the crispy?
Crispy chicken. You know.
Crispy, oh, crispy
KFC.
Chicken.
Crispy. It's a nice name, you know. I like Crispy. It's a good name.
Good name.
I think Crispy wins the award for best name. EU 14,
right.
Crispy. I like
the
it. Baylor I like
name
it.
Competition. Here we go. Let's see what they can pull together here. Magic has happened many times with those PT-50s. What are they going to pull out the hat here? Oh, look, they're going a bit aggressive there. Oh. Right then.
You can't outpeak them. You cannot outpeak Titan. Their aim is just on point. They know exactly where you are at every single moment. And the best choice that you have is to play something that is not really standard. Something like this, which almost bagged a kilt.
And now he's sleeping with the fishes. Oh,
he is actually.
He's actually sleeping with the fishes.
That's free dinner for the fish. Right
oh
into
God.
The pond. They didn't have to work. They didn't have to do anything for that. It was free delivery.
Man,
by
be,
Titan.
That'd be the best way to defend the bomb, so just put piranhas in there instead.
Well, they plant the bomb.
They're planting the bomb, piranhas jumping out, biting them. Biting them, it's going to be pretty tough.
Should be a new item in CSGO, the piranha trap.
Yeah.
Put it near water. Oh, Existence again, getting those shots through the smoke. His game sense is absolutely amazing. He always gets these kills through the smoke and through, like, you know, through the walls, and it just shows that he knows exactly where his enemies are. And that's why he's the team captain of one of the best teams in the world. There's a reason for that. Definitely a reason for that.
Actually, that's actually a really good point, because you only really see this done excessively well with the very, very, very top of the top teams, where you see the spam battles through smokes, because the teams, they can play with their eyes closed. They know the map so well and all the angles so well. Because the smoke obscuring it, they still know the most likely places for you to stand. They can just precision aim on that spot.
Exactly.
So that only the top teams can counterplay that by like not standing in those spots. But if you're like kind of below that echelon, you've just learned how to spam those spots. That's where you stand. So you're going to get completely decimated,
exactly,
as we saw
exactly.
by the experience of Titan. And Crispy, a nice little defense there from the Speedway. As MBK pushes his way up with that SIG through to quad, hole punch through successfully, and Scream working the tap magic.
I love
Michael
him.
Flatley is proud.
I love his aim. You know, it's so different from any other player. There is no player who has that tapping play. Oh, goodness me, Fiasco get the better of him, though. It's him against MBK 1-on-1. You could make it 13-2. If he's clever enough. Nice flash there. That's going to push MBK back, but MBK will take him down. As I was saying, Scream, honestly, you know, he's just got this type of gameplay to him. It might not be the best type of gameplay. It might not be, you know, the most effective type of play, but it's the most enjoyable to watch, really. But 14-1, for Titan coming into the second half. They only need two rounds to, you know, put o4o onto the loser's bracket. And we'll start off here on the pistol round. The Titan side playing on the stronger CT side on this map. It's very improbable here for o4o to do much, unless they've got some very, very nice T stats here. Nice by Fiasco, actually, supporting his teammates all the way from T-ramp with that flash and staying back, just in case there's a rotation by the CTs, and that's a good choice by him. Actually, they're giving away the bombsite at the moment, it looks like it. There's not really a lot of... Oh my goodness, Existence will get the first kill. Will he get the third? Two for him, putting it on a three-on-two situation. Now the Terrorists still have a chance of winning this round, and I take everything I said back. It's three-on-one. Scream is the last man standing. Will he be able to do anything in this situation? It looks like it might be a pistol round for o4o. The bomb is planted, and there's not a lot of time for Scream. He throws that nade there on the boiler. Scream. Will be shot down there by Madman. 14-2, o4o. Having the best start of their lives at the moment. They've won the pistol round. They can win the subsequent rounds after that. But it was a good bombsite B, bombsite A execute, sorry. Very confident in that push. And yep. They didn't have many CTs really stopping them on our side.
Yeah, it's really tough. Like once the Glocks get close range, we saw Titan making the kind of double peak in this area, which is really important to do because you try to capitalize at the start of the round on the range advantage of the CT pistols. The range is much better on the longer distances, but mid and close, the Glocks start to do really well, and you can start jumping around with Glocks so that they're body-shotting you. It's much harder for them to get a headshot, and you're fairly accurate. It's burst firing and stuff. They're hitting you in the armor, and that's not going to do much. You close the distance, and the Glocks are scary as hell. And Titan, they didn't get any of those opening picks. Then they had to face a close distance. They took some nice, you know, surprise setups like Existence in the back of the site. But as we can see, the Glocks did really well. You know, very good job by o4o. They're now slowly making that anti-eco play, able to constantly make trades, keep track of all their weapons, and playing together, pushing in slowly, considered, into the bombsite. They go Fiska, the pistoler. And he's going to go down, but the entry frag was pretty good. Kenny S coming in from the site here with that CZ.
Oh, yeah.
Do not underestimate him. As we see a bit of jerking there from the server.
What a beautiful smoke there by the CTs. They completely shut down the push by o4o, put them between a rock and a hard place, and they're going to have to back away. They got completely decimated by the pistols of Titan, and that's why they're one of the best teams in the world. Even on an eco round, they're able to stop that very aggressive Terrorist push with some really well-placed smokes, and that gave Kenny S the perfect angle to take down some of the Ts. Great job. As Quicks is the last man standing, they're probably able to pick up some of the guns that the Ts dropped. And Kenny S there with the Galil of his enemies, using it for full advantage. It's 15-2 match point here in today's game. Titan looking very, very strong indeed.
Yeah, that was really, really bad for them. I mean, they got caught by a really nasty crossfire around this area after making it through to quad. That crossfire with the nades that Titan had, it just works really, really, really effectively. And, you know, having all those weapons down, what can Quicks do there? To our stand, absolutely nothing. So Titan with a very nice setup, a stack that works out for them, and it doesn't always work. It's a bit of a gamble, but in that situation it did. And we're seeing Fiska with that Galil. What can he do with it? They know that it's over if they don't win this one. They had to scrap together the buy that they could. Armors, PT-50s, it's what we're left with now for o4o. And they are looking at, you know, elimination right now from this match.
And you can see the CT side for Titan is just so much more fluid. You can see how they switch positions, oh my goodness. Should have had an epilepsy warning there, like a seizure warning for people. You might get seizures watching this stream. But you can see the CT side is so much more mobile here for Titan. They're always switching. Don't have one guy in outside, one guy at truck side or at quad, and one guy in apartments all the time. It's always switching around. They might have three on one side, three on another, because that's the thing with bombsite A, is that you are able, if you're able to hold one side, you can pretty much hold the other side. And especially if you have pit, if you have two men in pit and one in quad, it's definitely possible to hold the bomb site even if they're coming from outside. And if they go towards bomb site B, you can either flank them or they're going to meet the CTs on the other side, as long as you have the information that that's going on. But sadly, 0-for-0, getting pretty badly decimated there by Titan, 16-2. And I guess the kind of pattern that we are pretty much experiencing since yesterday is continuing, where we're seeing the top teams, you know, doing very, very well against those that are not as high, I think. But
it's one of those things. I mean, they're going to be a team that hopefully, or at least players, because we know that, you know, CS players and teams tend to just go all over the place often enough. Yeah. But if they end up sticking together, it doesn't matter because all those players are getting very valuable experience. And that's what this experience is about for them. Like, this is DreamHack experience, more LAN experience. They get, you know, to play against these top teams. It's motivating. Even if you lose against them, it's inspiring to play the best.
They didn't do too bad, to be honest. They did. They had some great rounds and they had some great movements. But late game or mid round and late round, Titan were just too much better. Consistent throughout. But as we can see, Reason at the moment winning against Hellraisers 8-4. Reason Gaming, the Danish side, and Hellraisers, the team that came in with no strats.
We have no strats. Hopefully, we see a good result from them because I think everyone still wants them to do really well because they got such a great mix of players.
I've been watching their Twitch streams lately, and they're quite fun. It's fun to watch them, although I don't understand what they're saying. But they are playing on Inferno for those interested. Hellraisers versus Reason. I have to learn Russian or Ukrainian so I can watch it. But it seems like a good fun. They do get quite a lot of viewers. But it looks like might be Reason playing against Titan in the next game, and Hellraisers against o4o. There is a chance for o4o to stay in this, you know, especially if they're playing against a side that supposedly has no strats. You never know. I mean, the Ukrainians might be a bit shocked by o4o. Maybe it might be an interesting map. So it's probably the game that we'll have to be casting next. But Titan really showing everyone that they're really back into it. You know, there's no cracks in the team. There's no, like, weaknesses, and I'm 100% sure they played against o4o without showing their real strats, especially on the T side. They don't want to show what they're capable of. They don't want to show what the machinations that the existence has been cooking up over there in the gaming house in Brussels or in Belgium. So there's a lot more to see from that team. And I think Titan are in a strong position to actually at least minimally reach the semifinals, perhaps reach the finals.
I think also, like, games like that for Titan are actually really, really nice because you get to enter a game and you're thinking to yourselves, okay, we know that we're much better players. We just have to play great Counter-Strike. We just have to let Scream be Scream. You know, Kenny S, go be Kenny S. You know, there's much more freedom with the players because there's a huge element of Counter-Strike and with team play and chemistry. And when you remove the strats, like, you know, okay, Markle was saying, we have no strats, you can still play really damn well. If all of your teammates have a very good understanding of Counter-Strike, you know, okay, if your mate's standing here, then you have to be supporting the plays that he's thinking about. You know what he's thinking in that position, so you don't then know how to support him. And you're playing just a very, very free level of Counter-Strike at the top level. And that's going to really help them because when they're playing top, top, top teams, that has to be a little bit more tapered.
You have to shackle your players a bit, because what they did against o4o was just to outpeak them. They checked every single angle. They probably threw a few flashes, smokes here to better turn off the angles and whatnot. But really, it was outpeaking them at every single moment. MBK just rushing through, outpeaking them. Existence rushing through, Scream, Kenny S. They're all doing the same thing. So, and they weren't showing any of their strats, any of their kind of, crazy smokes and flashes that we expect to see from existence. So
it's just
standard calls, standard pushes and standard splits. But they were able to beat o4o very, very confidently. So that's going to be great for their confidence, and they're going to go into the next stage really, you know, in good spirits. Most likely playing against Reason Gaming.
Certainly. So I guess, guys, we're going to go to a break. We'll be back with more Counter-Strike action here on the B-Stream for DreamHack Summer. So you better stick with us to see what is up. And, of course, we are the most handsome stream. So if that's a thing for you, then came to the right place. But check out the platform if you've got a delay, if you've got any time to do so. Get those placement matches played. Get yourself ranked so you can play with others around your level in the new leagues and ladders and so on.
You'll see me in Master League, yeah. If you're playing Master League, you'll probably meet me in one of those games.
Really?
Yeah, just don't call me a hacker because I'm too good. You know, people might think I'm a hacker, but I'm not. I'm actually pro. I was asked to play as a substitute for a Clan Mystic, or now they're called Team Epsilon. So yeah.
I'm lying.
Right. I said that to GMX. I was like, GMX, can I play as a stand-in in E-Star? So he just goes, ha 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 ha, lol. I like you, but you suck. And
I like you, but you suck.
Thanks, man. Thanks. You could have joked. You could have said, yeah, sure. You know, it's not like I was going to play, but what to do?
All right. These pro players. On that very sad note, we're going to a break. See you guys later.
Take care.